What's up, y'all? This is Hussein Nasser from iGeometry, where we discuss software engineering by example. Today's topic is scalability and REST. I got a lot of questions from you guys asking to explain why is REST really scalable. So some of you read the Wikipedia article, and it's just filled of theoretical examples, right? So what we do here in iGeometry is basically try to come up with concrete examples to illustrate this concept. So let's get to it. How about that, guys? So so we're gonna take two examples to explain how REST is really scalable. So two concrete examples, hopefully. So let's go back. So the first one, let's go back in 2000, the year 2000, 2005, and 2004, where the client-server architecture was very popular. So you would basically have your database, and let's say this is Oracle 11G, right? Version 11G, right? And then you have all your fancy clients here, correct? These are your Windows machine or your Linux machine or desktop clients. Back in 2004, this was a very popular architecture, maybe still used, right? So you have all these machines, and then those guys basically connect to the Oracle database. This is some sort of a LAN setup, right? So this is all of these exist in the same network, essentially. And then you have this scales, like there's a lot of clients, maybe 20 of them, maybe 30, and there's like an Oracle application installed in each of them. And let's say you build an application that basically connects to the database and does something, right? So that you built an application, a desktop application. And on top of that application, there is obviously you would need to talk to the Oracle database, right? In order to do that, you would need the Oracle client. So your client need to understand how to talk to the database. So you would need the correct Oracle client, or and if you're using another database, you would need to, for example, SQL Server, you need the SQL Server client libraries, kind of in your reference in your project. It was a very popular at that time. So let's say you would need Oracle 11G client libraries, right? And that's your application. And application is using that, and then you can store, do stuff on your application, like write records, read records, and all that. And all these guys basically do the same thing, right? So all of them uses the Oracle client 11G, and you can see the coupling here. So not only that, everybody basically connects to this Oracle database. So let's say this is a LAN. So what is this is the original client server architecture, correct? So what is the problem with this design? The problem is, as you may have noticed, like what if now, few years later, I want to upgrade my database, and I heard that 12c is the thing now, so I want to upgrade to Oracle 12c. But guess what? The client, which are Oracle 11g client libraries, are not compatible with Oracle 12c. Oh man, you have to go into each machine and then upgrade this client to the Oracle 12c client, right? You have to go through each machine, uninstall and reinstall the new client. So what this, again, this in a big enterprise, this could be like hundreds of machines. This becomes really ugly, and to a point that it's almost impossible to do, right? It's almost very, very hard to do, because first you have to bring the database down, and you have to bring all these clients on. You can gradually upgrade one by one, and this could take weeks in order to do that. So this could slash some of your time, productive time, and this could really become really problematic. So what do you do? Right, there's no solution. You have to do it one by one. And the problem was because the server was tied to the client, or the other way around. The server is very, very, very coupled to the client, right? Because of this component that you have to install on the client. And that where REST came and said, I'm going to do something. The representational stateful, representational state transfer protocol. What it did is it says, okay, I'm going to separate the concerns from the server of a client. The server is alone, and the client is alone, and there is one single protocol that communicate. You cannot use your own fancy protocol here like this, in this case, where it requires coupling and certain libraries to be installed in the actual machine in order to know how to connect to a database, right? So what REST did, it says, okay, you can still have your Oracle 11G here, but you have to do is install a server on top of that. Could be in the same machine, could be another machine. Doesn't really matter, right? You have to do that. Web server, and then these guys, you have to rewrite your application to not use the Oracle client libraries, but instead to use pure, beautiful HTTP. That's what you do. That's the separation of concern here. So that's how REST is scalable in this scenario only, right? I'm not even talking about stateless at all here. And who now needs to understand how to talk to the database? This guy needs to. That's the only guy that needs to understand. So that's, you need to, the Oracle 11G client libraries only here, okay? And then obviously there's the communication between the web server and the database. So what we do is like these guys, this is like, you could build a web application essentially, right? And it could be a browser, could be a desktop application. Doesn't really stop you from doing it. You can use desktop application to communicate through HTTP, right? And then all these guys connect to the web server, and then this web server connects to the Oracle database. So why is this useful? We separated the server from the client, kinda, right? So there's a huge separation. There is a huge decoupling that we did. Now, if I want to upgrade my database, guess what? I only upgrade my database, and guess what? Few servers. That's it, right? And you can basically create a testing environment here where you replicate that thing, right? You can keep those as 11G. You can basically make the new environment 12C as a testing environment. Then you create replication, all these cool stuff. And then once you're ready for production, you basically point all your guys to the new server and you retire the old server. And just like that, you are really, you scaled up, right? So this becomes a very easy method of scalability. The server can scale independently of the client, and the client can, those guys can uninstall the Windows and install a new Windows. It doesn't really matter because it's the communication is done through HTTP. Whereas here, even the client is locked. If your enterprise said, hey guys, we want to try Windows 10, I thought it's really cool, but it says, Oh, I don't think we can do this because I don't think Oracle 11G client libraries is compatible with the Windows 10. So you run into all these problems and weird scenarios, right? So all kind of couplings is in general bad. I don't know how much time we left, but I think I'm going to leave the second example for another episode where we talk about stateless. Guys, there is another video that I made comparing stateless versus stateful architecture, and that also allow high availability and high scalable solution. So check out that video. I'm going to link it here it was a really popular video. My channel doesn't have really most subscribers, but people were finding this video because they were searching stateless versus stateful. And I think we became really popular. I think people really found it useful. All right, guys, that is all for me today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you are new to this channel, consider subscribing. I from time to time, I make some examples like that. We talk about software engineering by example here on this channel. All right, guys, stay awesome. I'm going to see you on the next one. Have a good day.